Hello dosto, I am Mohanish and today in this video I'll be showing some of my favorite projects that I have developed on my own. So I'll show you few of my favorite projects. So I'll just go live because this is a HTML, CSS and JS project. So you see I'm getting like a company like a domain which like Expenlizer. And see and learn how to keep accounts of your money. Join Expenlizer today. So this is what I made. So I'm only getting my username part and I'm not getting the password part because the database, like databases means like where you store the data, has expired because it was a Firebase thing. So you see I got like Expenlizer Hive. If your username is not visible, then it's like here, like how much credits you got, here it would show, and how you want to credit something to your amount, and how much debits means how much did you give, and like there's a debit button, and you can even do the banking over here, and it's like a glossary. I mean, like actually, it was like a competition of a regional level, and I got the first place for making this. So it is like and it was told to make it for kids, so that's why I added a glossary also, right? Like what meanings like that, online banking, and down you can see it develop my Mohanish and all that. And here you can see like a like navigation bar. So if I click credit, it takes me to the credits. If I click debit, it takes me to the debit. Glossary, it takes me to the glossary. And contacts are not there, and Expenlizer takes you to the top of the page. So I will tell like why like most of the features don't work here, because the database expired as I told. So see, so how, where do I make the databases? So here you have something called Firebase, and so I'll just open it, Firebase console. So it is like a project, like this is a different project. I'll just go to Firebase, and you see like my Expenlizer has expired, the project has expired already, so it shows remove this app and all that, it has expired already fully. And here I think a few accounts are there. I think I cleared the database. Yeah, here few accounts are there, like who used it with username, password, and I have authentication and everything. Like here are few users who actually used my app. Like I don't know, like people gave names. I made it like safe, so I have the passwords, but I made like, because I am the like domain, so I need the passwords. So I made it like you can only see the usernames for safety, if you know, so others can't see it quickly. So here people joined with like many names, but like I am not able to control because it has expired and like people are not joining now. And I'll show you my like one more project. I think that is not, I have to open the folder. So it's that Datilizer. So this project is a recent project which I made for like the All India level competitions, and I secured the second place for this project. It is quite simple. It's a D3JS project. So if you don't know D3JS, so I'll tell you the full form of D3. So that is driven data documents. It's a library in JavaScript. So library in JavaScript are like modules in Python. So please don't get confused. And this is also a project made with HTML, JavaScript and CSS. And CSS cascading style sheet. It's used for styling the HTML, and JavaScript for making functions. So you see it's quite simple. I didn't concentrate a lot on the UI, and you see I'm getting like this is key. So here actually what I mean by key is to write the name, and value is like value as if you, and I here I can set the scale limit also, only for graphs. So graphs are a bar graph and lollipop graph, and here pie chart and donut chart also you can create. So I'll just add a few like data. So here I added like 9 days. I adding the data like number of pieces of cloth sold in like month, first 9 days of the month. So here I like to give 100, then 200, then 300, 400, 500, then 450, then 550, then 350, and then 670 and all. So here if I create a bar graph, so you see I get a bar graph. I set the default scale limit to 1000. So here actually what I need, I can just complete it by 700 only, like the scale limit. I'll again create it. So you see I get a 700 scale limit, and I'm getting it from highest to lowest. So day 9 I got highest sales, and day 1 I got least sales, and day 8 has medium sales. It has like 350 sales, and you see you can do much more than that. And I'll show you one error statement. So here if I don't give an item and give a number and create it, so it will show me an error like please fill out the object for value 9. So see, so here I have to fill like the day 9, because that's the error statement I have given. So you should remember that you need to keep the error statements as well in your program. Also user, you know that what you are making, so you can use it very easily without, because you know this will be an error, so you won't do that. But users don't know that, so you need to even create error statements. And actually creating the error statement took me around 200 to like 500 lines of code. So that's a big deal, and that's very important. So you can even create pie charts here, donut charts, lollipop charts. I had a transition for this, and you can even download each type of chart. I have a download button over here, and you see I can just download it. And see, I'll just open it and show it to you. And you see it works perfectly fine. I coded it as like that, and only the bar graphs get low, like downloaded, not the other, the key. And you can even do same for pie chart and all that. I'll just show you the one for the pie chart also. So this one is one chart, and this is one chart, and this is one graph. And you see I'm able to download both charts and graphs. So that's what the app was, and it was around like 2000 lines of code. So please don't try to make a replica of it, because you need a like deep knowledge about d3.js, because this full project is full made like d3.js, and I was learning it for like so much time, and it was very hard. And this is a quitter, like you can say I tried to make a replica of like Twitter. So I named it quitter, I didn't get good names. So I'll just run this. Even this had a database and it expired, so it doesn't works like as it used to work before. So you see, this is how you like user login. Here also it's not showing the password, so I'll just type my name. So I'll just log in, and you see I have room name, welcome Monish. I can log out also. I have one message, I did not see, and it's like add room. So I'll just add a room, like click. So, and if another user who is also in the room, like this click room, so he can also message to me that was a little error type, because like people don't need to I don't need to add people, like people can just come to my room by just typing click. So that's how it's like a Twitter, not like WhatsApp. So I just added the room. I can message here, I send, and the message not getting sent because my database expired. So next time I would try to show you the same things with the databases. I'll renew the databases, so it takes a lot of time. And I'll show you I have a project in Python. So that's like a Flappy Bird. So you can see I have a bunch of audio clips and pictures, and this is the py main.py. So here you can see I imported a random. So random is for getting random numbers. SYS means system, and pygame. From pygame I imported locals, and from locals I imported all. So I set the FPS means frames per second to 32 screen width, screen height, and screen AI, and the player is the like from gallery, sprites folder, and bird.png background and pipe and all that. This is welcome screen. There are two functions, welcome screen and main game. And I just did this. And here I kept like while true, welcome screen and main game. So I'll just run the program and show it to you all. I'll just kill the PowerShell terminal. So you see, game window comes here, Flappy Bird. So it's very similar. You can play with spacebar or up arrow. So I'll play it. See, and I died, and again it showed me get ready and all that. So I can play it. See, I scored 1 point, I scored 3 points, I scored my 4th point, and I died. And that's how the game goes. So if you have any ideas about making like apps or websites or anything like this, you can tell me in the comment section. And I'll be very happy if you would type a comment and like the video and subscribe my channel. And most important, this is my most favorite project and the most helping project. It like this has no database and all that, so it is like very simple. So I named this program Jarvis. Like, you understand what you mean now. Jarvis is Iron Man's AI and all that. So I'll just show you. Very simple, like I did it, like simply. So you have a time, you have a charging, and your location and all that. Your small button is start recognition and online. And if I just disconnect my internet, it shows me offline with orange color, right? So this like is very great, like huge code. And like if I start showing you all the like functionalities of Jarvis, then it would take more than one video, and I don't want to make this video so much long. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel and like this video, so I get motivation to make like this videos. And thanks for watching.